Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain BPSK, Binary Phase Shift Keying, in this session. Now see, this session is little bit different compared to other shift keying. As I have seen, students were requesting to explain me constellation diagram and how we can make constellation diagram. So for that, I have made this session to explain BPSK, where I'll explain you complete detail, like what is BPSK, how we can make constellation diagram. After that, based on constellation diagram, I'll explain you its transmitter circuit, right? So see, as per the name BPSK, it is binary phase shift keying, where as it is binary, M is equals to 2 for that. So here there are two signals, X1T and X2T. X1T, that is associated with, let us say, 1, and X2T, let us say, that is associated with 0. Now see, if I say I have a carrier signal that is having frequency fc, then generalized carrier signal will be here, carrier signal, let us say c of t, then that is a cos of 2 pi fc t with somewhat phase, let us say it is phi. Now see, as name indicates, it is phase shift keying. So here this phi phase that will change for x1t, which is represented by bit 1, and x2t, that is represented by bit 0, right? And see, if I provide 0 phase with bit 1 and 180 degree phase with bit 0, in that case my x1t and x2t, that will be there based on frequency, but phase will be different. Like see, bit 0, that is there with phase phi is equals to 0, and bit 1, that is there with phase phi is equals to 180 degree, right? And if you place that, you'll be finding now x1t, that will be a cos of 2 pi fct, and x2t, now that will be a, see, now cos of 2 pi fct plus 180, so that will make minus of a cos of 2 pi fct. See, that is how bit 0 and bit 1, that will get represented in terms of symbol, right? Now my agenda is to represent this amplitude in terms of energy per bit. And as I have told, see, this is what representing bits. X1t, that represents bit 1, and X2t, that represents bit 0. So as per that, this time period t, that is there in between 0 to TB, where TB is bit duration, right? And for this bit duration, I want to derive this amplitude in terms of energy per bit, right? So if I say EB is energy per bit, then we can calculate EB as per, EB is equals to 0 to TB x1 square of t dt, right? Where x1 of t, that is this. So see, and here this signal is energy signal. BPSK signal is energy signal, it is not power signal, right? So that one should know. So energy per bit as per this signal, that will be 0 to TB x1 t square, so that is a square cos square 2 pi fct dt. A square is constant, take it outside. 0 to TB cos square theta, that is 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So here 1 plus 4 pi fct divided by 2 dt. So this half will come ahead. So a square by 2 and integration of 1 plus cos of 4 pi fct dt. That is what we are delivered to identify. Now see, this is a square by 2 and integration of 1, that is tb over here, but integration of cosine or sine over a period of 0 to t, that has to be 0. So this integration, that is tb only, right? So energy per bit, that is a square by 2 into tb. So from this we can say amplitude, that is tb. So that is how we can convert this amplitude in terms of energy per bit. Now see, as amplitude is this, now I can again rewrite x1t and x2t in terms of eb and tb, right? So now my signals x1t and x2t, now that will change to right, and this is representing bit 0 and this is representing bit 1. So x1t, that is representing bit 1, and x2t, that is representing bit 0. So that is how I have represented bit 1 and bit 2 in terms of energy per bit as amplitude. Now see, our agenda is to plot constellation diagram, and from constellation diagram we will make a circuit of transmitter for BPSK, right? So for constellation diagram, we should know Gram-Smith orthogonalization procedure, and that will identify number of basis function, and based on number of basis function we can say what will be my constellation diagram, right? So what are the dimensions which is there with my signal, and based on that we can have plotting of constellation diagram. So let me mention, as per Gram-Smith we will find number of basis functions, and number of basis functions, if I say that is n, then that is always less than or equal to m, and here m is equals to 2 for our case. So n has to be lower than or equal to 2. So first agenda is to identify how many n's are there, means how many number of basis functions are there in our problem, right? So how to identify basis functions? So see, let me say my first basis function, that is phi 1 of t, and that is x1 of t divided by eb, square root of eb. Now x1 of t, that we have already calculated in terms of energy per bit, so let me mention it over here, 2 eb by tb divided by square root of eb into cos of 2 pi fct. So this eb will get cancelled, and you will be finding simplified one will be 2 divided by square root of 2 divided by tb cos of 2 pi fct, right? So this is my basis function. Now see here, if you observe this x1t and x2t, so here one thing that we can directly say, like see, x1 of t is equals to minus of x2 of t, right? See, as per 180 degree out of phase, x1 of t, that is equals to minus x2 of t. So here only one basis function that is required, right? As it is having a function with single frequency, you don't need other basis function. Other basis function is required only if you have other frequency component, right? But here one can represent both of this symbol by having direct relation, as only single frequency is there. So here we have only one basis function, so n is equals to 1, and as we have only one basis function, we can say BPSK that is having one dimensional modulation. As it is having only one basis function, we can say BPSK that is having one dimensional modulation scheme. And now see, as per this, our agenda is to identify constellation diagram, right? And as per orthogonalization, we can even say integration of this phi 1 of t over bit duration tb, that should be equals to 1. And that is what even we can easily derive. If you do this integration, you will be finding that is equals to 1 even. Right, I am not going to derive this, but this is what, as per orthogonalization, that we can say. And this is very simple, even you can derive it. Now, our agenda is to identify constellation points, right? Or one can say scatter plot, or one now see, constellation point that we can identify as per basic formula as x of ij, that is equals to integration limit is from 0 to tb xit into phi j dt, where i varies from 1 to m, and this j that varies from 1 to n, where n is number of basis function and m is number of symbols, right? And as per this, we can have two constellation points, right? I is having two possible values, 1 and 2, and j is having only one possible value, that is 1, as n is equals to 1. So we have only two constellation point, x11, and second constellation point is x12, right? Sorry, x21. So let us place values, right? So x1t into phi 1t dt, and this is 0 to tb. x2t into phi 1t dt. Now see, we can have this x1t in form of basis function, right? Like see, phi 1 that is this, so we can say x1t that is eb into phi 1t, right? So we can say x1t that is square root of eb into phi 1t, so this will become phi 1 square t dt, and here x2t that is minus eb into phi 1 square t dt. And if you take eb outside, this will be 0 to tb phi 1 square t dt, and over here this will be minus square root of eb outside . And as per orthogonalization, this is 1. So we can say x11 constellation point, that is eb, and this x21 constellation point, that is square root of minus eb, minus of square root of eb, right? So this is how we have two constellation point, and we have only one dimensional modulation. So as per this, we can plot constellation diagram, right? So let us plot constellation diagram, or one can say space. Now see, as it is one dimensional modulation, there is single line which is having basis function phi 1, right? So let me plot one dimensional line, right? And that is having basis function phi 1. Now on that basis function phi 1, there are two constellation point. One is square root of EB and second is square root of minus of square root of EB. So if I say here there is a reference minus EB that represents bit 0. And when you send this signal at receiver side, you will be observing in this region, at receiver side in this region, right? From 0 to positive infinity, you will be receiving bit 1. So if I say this is region 1, then from bit 1 infinity, we receive bit 0. And this is what decision threshold, right? And over this side, 0 to minus infinity, we will be receiving bit 0. Let us say this is region 0. So that is how constellation points are there. So at receiver side, in this region, we will be receiving bit 0. And at this side, we will be receiving bit 1. That is how we can identify constellation point. So see, constellation points, that is what we are plotting it with respect to basis function. And from basis function, we can identify how many dimensions are there with given scheme. And here, as it has only one frequency with phase shift keying, there is only one dimension with bit 0 and bit 1 that you can see it over here. Right. Now, our agenda is to understand what will be my transmitter diagram. So see, as we have only one basis function, all I'll be doing is I'll have phi 1 of t, that is my basis function, that is what I'll multiply it with energy eb. So there are two cases which we have: square root of eb and minus square root of eb that we have, right? So this square root of eb that is there with bit 1 and minus square root of eb that is there with bit 0. So this will be my input to this, and this is what my output, that is xij of t, right? Where you can say there are two signals that we have, which is what this constellation point, that one can say. Now here we have input that is binary, right? Here we have input that is binary, that is there in terms of 0 and 1. Now that is what we will be doing it with polar line coding, right? So we'll be having polar line coding scheme over here to have this energy with bit 1 and bit 0. So here we'll be having polar line coding, and this is what making my transmitter diagram for BPSK. I hope that you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos.